Welcome to the Simulation Center at the University of Alaska. My name is Marissa Carello, the simulation technician providing your tour. You're viewing this video because you've registered for your labs and simulation is on your course schedule. What is simulation? Simulation is a technique that uses a situation or environment created to allow persons to experience a representation of a real event for the purpose of practice, learning, evaluation, testing, or to gain understanding of systems or human actions, with the goal of understanding and managing the situation better when it occurs in actual clinical practice. How will the experience be valuable to you? Not only at UAA, but internationally, simulation is used as a learning tool in medical fields to create reflective, competent, and professional practitioners. The simulation experiences engage in scenarios that employ leadership and delegation roles, collaborate with the interprofessional healthcare team, perform safety measures, exercise communication skills, critical thinking, and decision making. Simulation allows experiences of events that may not be experienced in the clinical setting. Simulation engages in real life situations in real time. And most importantly, simulation allows mistakes to be made without compromising patient safety. It is important that you take time to view this orientation before your first simulation experience. Let me show you around to prepare you for your simulation exercise. Before we enter this patient room, take note you must wear gloves and that the patient is allergic to betadine and ink. Actually, the manikin's skin can be damaged by the natural oils from our hands. Betadine and ink cannot be easily removed. The first thing that you will do when you enter the simulation patient room is to put on gloves. We have small, medium, large, and extra large. In this high-fidelity patient room, Laerdal's Sim Baby is the usual patient. To name a few of Sim Baby's features, you may auscultate heart, lung, and blood pressure, practice airway occlusion and intubation, monitor ECG, cyanosis, and seizing. The list goes on. In this next patient room, we have Laerdal's Sim Man 3G. Similarly to Sim Baby, you can auscultate heart and lung sounds. You can also auscultate bowel sounds. You can check his various pulses. We have pedal pulses, popliteal, femoral, radial, brachial, and carotid. You can also monitor his blood pressure, pupillary responses, practice airway occlusion and intubation, monitor ECG, cyanosis, and seizing. Simman 3G also has the ability to cry, sweat, froth at the mouth, and urinate.
Go away.
And communicate as well. Vital Sim manikins, medium fidelity manikins, are often used in simulation too. They are medium fidelity because they do not have as many realistic features as the Sim Baby nor the Simman 3G. Despite that, they are the most used because they still satisfy and meet many of your basic objectives. You may auscultate lung and heart and bowel sounds, monitor blood pressure, and perform skills like straight catheter insertion, nasogastric tube insertion, and tracheostomy care. We have the simulation room set up with areas to mimic the hospital setting, such as a supply room and medication room. Although we have most of the supplies needed for each scenario in the room, the users can still delegate another person to gather additional supplies if needed. Medications are located in the mini med bins with a variety for you to select from, in addition to the other various supplies that we have here in these drawers. We've also added supply bins that allow you to use your assessment, critical thinking, and technical skills. We provide bins for oxygen, wound care, trach care, IV therapy, and cath care. You also have the crash cart filled with necessary drugs and supplies to have a simulated code. We have an X-ray viewer, a patient monitor, an oxygen panel, assessment tools, and a phone that allows you to call any provider that you need during your exercise. Your instructor will be behind the one-way glass with me, and they will play any role that you need when you make that call. An important aspect of the simulation experience is the debriefing session that occurs with your teammates, your instructor, and you. During your simulation exercise, you'll be audio and video recorded. There are cameras and microphones mounted in the ceilings of the simulation labs to record your performance and interventions. At the end of your simulation exercise, the recording will be played back for your team and instructor for debriefing and guided reflection on the learning objectives that were set. Not to worry, the recordings are deleted immediately after your debriefing session. Time for the golden rules of simulation. Think of these golden rules as your expectations in your simulation exercises. You are expected to follow these rules to have a valuable simulation experience. Number one, Vegas mentality. Just like in Vegas, what happens in this simulation room stays in this simulation room. Please don't discuss the scenario or interventions with anyone other than your current group members or instructor. We want every user to have the same opportunity for a first-time experience. Do not share information because we are also practicing HIPAA confidentiality, just like you would encounter in the clinical setting. Number two, make mistakes. You have to make mistakes. You will make mistakes. We want you to make mistakes. This is a safe learning environment that allows users to make mistakes without harm. The point of the exercises to take your mistakes and turn them into learning experiences. This is truly a learning opportunity being provided to enhance your clinical knowledge and time. We would rather you make mistakes in the simulation room than in the actual clinical setting. Number three, don't waste your time. Treat this like an actual professional setting. Act as if you are truly taking care of a patient in a real hospital room. Use your time to practice skills as well as professionalism, communication, delegation, teamwork, and critical thinking. Number four, do no harm. We all want to make sure that we do no harm when caring for patients. Simulation is another tool to help prevent this from occurring in the clinical setting. So that wraps up the golden rules of simulation: Vegas mentality, make mistakes, don't waste your time, and do no harm. Please remember these rules throughout your practices. We're excited to have you, and we hope you are too. See you soon.